Hi, this is Shelley Kraft. We're coming to you live on SNN Live. We're at the Cambridge House California Resource Conference 2013 in Indian Wells. With me is a familiar face, Rick Rule of Sprott Global Resource Investing Limited. And it's a publicly traded company, SII on the TSX. Ladies and gentlemen, Rick Rule. How are you, Rick?
Fine, Shelley. Thank you for having me.
Now, you're a featured speaker at Cambridge House at this conference particularly. You're the buzz. What were you speaking about? Please tell our audience.
I had two messages. One, bullion. Obviously a bullish message with regards to bullion, but particularly platinum and palladium, which is a form of bullion that most people don't think about that I think people should think more about.
You know, I've heard about platinum and palladium in the last 10 days. I have to tell you. What is it about palladium and platinum that is so much now being talked about all of a sudden, and you're, who I'm hearing, is talking about it at this conference?
Simple supply and demand. We believe that the prices of platinum and palladium must go up, and we think they can go up, a unique set of circumstances. We also believe that other forms of bullion will go up for other reasons, but we think simple supply and demand will propel the prices of platinum and palladium higher.
Where is the demand coming from?
Most demand for platinum and palladium is an autocatalyst. It goes out a tailpipe, it goes up a smokestack, or in some cases it gets turned into jewelry. But in every case, unlike gold and silver, which often becomes bullion, platinum and palladium gets consumed. It goes away, and that's an important part of the story.
And you know, I'm hearing that there are things going on in China regarding platinum. And I think it has something to do with their auto industry. Am I correct?
That's correct. Most of the platinum and palladium that's used in the world is used as an autocatalyst. The political or social discussion is that you either use platinum or you have smog. The air quality that we enjoy in Southern California is a consequence of 40 years of catalytic conversion in vehicles. Air quality in China, to get back to your question, is deplorable. The Chinese government themselves have said that 500,000 Chinese citizens a year lose their lives to cardiopulmonary illness as a consequence of air pollution. The solution is platinum. In China, platinum and palladium loadings per new vehicle are less than 10% of U.S. loadings. The efficiency, the utility of platinum and palladium in the United States is such that there are continually new legislation to increase the use of platinum and palladium in a market that uses 10 times as much as China. We believe that China will increase platinum and palladium loadings per vehicle in what is now the largest motor vehicle market in the world.
Now, here's a question. Doesn't China have its own palladium and platinum?
No.
Zero?
Not zero, but what you need to know about platinum and palladium is, unlike gold and silver, which are produced ubiquitously around the world, platinum and palladium are produced in South Africa, Zimbabwe, and Russia. 90% of the world's new mine supplies of platinum and palladium come from South Africa, Zimbabwe, and Russia. And they all have their own problems.
Politically?
Yes.
Oh my. That's an issue.
There's another issue. With gold and silver, a whole lot of the gold and silver that has ever been mined is still supply. It's in the form of bullion. We do something strange, actually. We take it out of a hole in the ground called a mine, and we put it in a hole in the ground called a vault. With platinum and palladium, we don't do that. We mine it, and it goes out a tailpipe, it goes up a smokestack, or it gets turned into rings. In fact, the world's above-ground supply of platinum and palladium is less than 1 year's fabrication demand. So the only supply that you need to concern yourself with in terms of platinum and palladium pricing is new mine supply.
You're bringing a very important point to the surface, and that is, where do you go to find new platinum? Where do you go? Is Canada? Is it the U.S.? Is it Mexico? I mean, what stable economy? What stable political atmosphere? I mean, what else is out there?
The specific answer to the question is no, no, and no. If you go for platinum and palladium, you go to the shadow of a headframe of an existing mine. There is a lot of platinum and a lot of palladium in South Africa. The problem is, at this price point, the platinum and palladium industry on a global basis does not earn its cost of capital. We can't make continuing supplies of platinum available despite increasing demand at this platinum and palladium price because the industry does not earn their cost of capital. One of two things is going to happen. The price of platinum and palladium is going to go up, or the levels of smog that we all breathe are going to increase, and they're going to increase substantially. You live in Southern California. You remember the air quality in Southern California in the 60s.
It was Mexico City.
It was not pretty. And what stands between us and that is catalytic conversion, platinum and palladium.
Okay, so you've now addressed the situation, you've addressed the remedy, you've addressed the need, you've even addressed the lack of supply. So how does an investor, who is our audience, take advantage of your information? What would you tell investors to do at this point?
Well, my preference would be that the investors bought the Sprott Physical Platinum and Palladium Trust, which trades on the New York Stock Exchange. This trust, this product, came as a consequence of us discovering 18 months ago that we couldn't recommend any platinum or palladium stocks to our investor base because none of them earned their cost of capital. We thought, since none of the companies can make any money, if you want to participate in platinum and palladium, what you have to do is buy platinum and palladium.
What's the symbol of that New York trust?
SPPP.
SPPP. Okay, continue.
There are other platinum and palladium ETFs, and it is possible to buy platinum and palladium physically through some bullion dealers. Our belief is that our product is superior, particularly for American investors, because our product, if we're correct, and we think we will be, is taxed at the capital gains rate because it's structured as a trust, while collectibles and the ETFs, which are regarded as bullion proxies, are taxed at the income or collectibles rate. So there's, under current tax legislation, a substantial substantial benefit for U.S. holders to own the trust form of bullion as opposed to the ETF or the physical form of bullion.
So instead, they're only faced with short-term or long-term capital gains and not an income experience on their taxable income, correct?
Correct.
So this is now interesting. So this seems to have a gross departure from all the other minerals and metals. This seems to have now, you may have been talking about it for 15 months, but I don't think anybody else has, and I don't think it's really come to the surface, really, until right now.
It took us, I think, 14 months to get approval from the Toronto Stock Exchange and the New York Stock Exchange to launch this. Given that we knew that we were going to go into the market to buy $250 or $300 million worth of physical metal, it was not in our interest to tell this story broadly until we had a cleared prospectus and were enabled by the New York Stock Exchange to raise the money to buy it. You can understand why, for the 14 months while the issue was in registration, it was not in my interest to stand in front of an audience and get a whole bunch of people to front run me.
No one has ever accused Sprott of not being smart.
Well, we've done a lot of things right over time. The last 2 years have been unpleasant for everybody in the precious metals and natural resource business. But if you look back to the 20 years before the last 2 years, the Sprott name has been synonymous with performance.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, people look up to Sprott for guidance as well and leadership in the marketplace. Ladies and gentlemen, Rick Rule, Sprott Global Resource Investment Limited, symbol SII on the TSX. I'm Shelley Kraft. This is SNN Live. We're at the Cambridge House California Resource Conference 2013 here in Indian Wells, California. Rick, thanks for coming on.
Shelley, thanks for the opportunity.
Good to have you.